Hi there, beautiful dreamers. Welcome back to Mia Soleil Dreamwork. Sometimes it's needed to go back into a dream. If, for example, having the same dream repeatedly, really scary nightmares, or if the dream just feels very unfinished. And when going back into a dream, the very best is to have a co-dreamer on the journey, because when someone being there dreaming the same dream at the same time, it's not only that there is someone else able to see more details, perceive things, it's also a safety for the dreamer. This extra guidance is needed at least in the beginning, but later on, when having some experience, one is quite capable to handle it by oneself if necessary. And when doing that, one also discovers how to direct one's life into a more harmonious way through forming the awake dream. The last time I really needed to go back into a dream, it was to be able to find out who was driving a car. That made me lose all my power only by seeing it on a distance. I had no co-dreamer at the moment, since I was at a cottage, kind of in the middle of nowhere, and my husband, who was with me, was quite busy with something, and I really didn't want to wait, because patience has never been one of my gifts. The good thing was that I was already quite an experienced dream traveler, and also that in the dream there actually was someone who functioned as a co-dreamer. So this is the dream. I'm going out from a small square house facing east. It's a pitch black winter night outside, and on the short stairs leading down to the square garden lays a thin layer of sparkling white snow. I take the steps down and walk the few meters on the shovel path between the short snowy walls of with the glimmering snow. In front of me flies a small spiritual being who is sparkling like stars, just as the snow does around us. It's all very beautiful. When I leave the yard, I turn left and start walking northwards, and the feeling is that I'm leaving my safety, but it doesn't matter, because I'm going to visit my mom and talk about astrological signs, and I'm so very happy the time has finally come. I'm walking on the right side on the empty snow white road towards north, and to the right of me is a high wall of snow. I'm wearing a white fur imitation coat, and all around me it's pitch black. But everything feels just right, and I'm very happy. Then behind me, a sound of an engine appears in the distance, and soon I can see the light beams of a car. This makes me quite powerless, and it's like all of my energy disappears, and the car comes closer, and I'm more and more feels like I can't really stand up. So when the car is some 20 meters behind, I have no power left at all, and I fall down on the road. I know I have to get up and get past that wall to the right of me, but a quite massive act of willpower is required, and I don't have it. So I just is there. So when I went back into that dream the first time, the small spiritual being who I lost contact with in the original dream, the moment I turned left and went north, gave me the strength I needed. I didn't lay down, because I had courage from this spiritual being, and together we both slid and flew down the snowy slopes towards north. And when we arrived, it was to my surprise in another dream, an older one, and there I became pretty aware of the obvious fact that this was the place where I lost my power so abruptly. It was kind of the epicenter of lost powers, because a part of me was actually struck there, which I had no clue about before. It was all very intriguing, coming back to that dream, but I still couldn't see the character in the car. It was hidden to me as was the present male character in the epicenter of lost power dreams. So I decided to use this initial dream as a material in a dream and a higher spiritual knowledge course I held together with a friend. And one of our brilliant students went back into the dream along with me, and she saw the person in the car who had been defying my attempts to see him. I had reason to revisit the dream many more times since the driver turned out to be a character who was known from earlier dreams. And the most striking thing was that this driver was also synonym to the male in the dream I saw surprisingly entered when going back to the initial dream by myself the first time. Then he only showed himself from the waist and down. This character who held my soul part as a prisoner. I found this soul part of me as an old mummified dry grass looking woman sitting in a dollhouse working with a spinning wheel. Her hair was stuck in a spider's web attached to the wall. After quite a few journeys back to both the dreams, I had not only identified and understood which aspects of myself the participants represented and seen the theme it caused repeatedly in my life, I had also brought home with me the lost soul part. It's quite touching. It took some heavy shame and work to do with this, but I really needed that lost part of myself who had been gone for eons. Such a blessing. And the thing is that we really can suffer from the lack of soul parts from incarnations so very long ago that we can't remember them. The loss keeps affecting us though, from lifetime to lifetime, and the drama repeats itself to make us aware of the fact of something is missing. In my case, the sign was fatigue adjacent to apathy, quite an unusual condition for me since I have always been the one who takes care of the situation wherever it whatever it takes. So since I had no clue about what caused it, even if I had begun to recognize the situation before the situation, as to say, I really had to identify the driver, the trigger, and the cause of the original wound. Otherwise, I couldn't change my reaction. It was a blind spot, and even if it was both unfrequently and rare, this apathy attacks, I had to find the cause. The cause that turned out to be a drama stuck in time, since a part of my soul was imprisoned in another dimension. So, as I said, one really can use a co-dreamer, especially if doing a deep dream work, going from one dream to another and when releasing soul parts, because that's actually work for experienced shamans. Working alone may end up in being stuck in heavy energies from which it may be a bit difficult to free oneself. There's a chakra in the back of the head called the Alta Major, functioning as a portal towards old incarnations, and that chakra is seated near the reptile brain. This means the fight or flight reflex is easily activated in such situations, which is actually not a bad thing, because it's kind of a guard on the threshold, kind of like you are now leaving the safe net, are you sure you want to continue? But the yes and no buttons are more like two reactions upon fear than two choices. So, and with the third reptil brain-oriented reaction at hand, as in ending up in shock, it should be pretty clear that deep dream work is not always like going on a Sunday picnic. So it's quite easy to become overwhelmed when the reptile brain is activated. Happily enough, new beginners don't disconnect to the awake mind that easily, so the risk isn't that big for something critical to happen, but it's needed to be said. The worst thing that happened to me when going out and about alone in my early OBEs was that I fell out of my bed when I without result tried to enter my body again. Quite a weird situation, but when my body fell, I felt the pain, and I was back into it in a blink of an eye. down to earth, the greatest benefit of having a co-dreamer is not fear of getting lost in another dimension, but having one extra set of senses observing the realm of the subconscious. And this kind of work can be used in real life, awake dream too. Example, if you can't find your key cards, then instead of running around swearing and getting all stressed out about it, you may sit down and relax into the last time you can remember you used the car keys. If someone is around and willing to help, it's perfect. Co-dreamer is always welcome, but this can absolutely be done alone, since it's kind of a light form of re-entering an awake dream. Some dreamers do easily step into the same dream and take on where they left the last night. But for the rest of us who don't, there are some shortcuts. If focusing on the last night's dream when going to bed, going through it from the beginning to its end, it's quite possible to re-enter the dream that way. And Dreamtime is dedicated to dreams, and that special kind of awareness one have during sleep comes naturally, and the possibilities are then unlimited. But most of us don't have the key to that place, and we have to wait for the dreams to, like, the same way as waiting for stars to fall randomly and in best case scenario kind of. So therefore learning to walk in and out of dreams using different techniques and doing it together with others is quite helpful. In native communities, dreams are really important, and they also dream together and alter the reality if necessary. It's definitely possible to get together in dream time to meet when asleep and working for the greater common. So how to do then, if wanting to re-enter a dream together with someone else? Well, the co-worker doesn't really need to be in the same room during the process. This can be done in a distance, but it must be done in the same time. The work before consists of information about the original dream. When the dreamer tells the co-dreamer everything he or she remembers about the dream, the place, the time, the season, direction, and so on, and of course the purpose for wanting to re-enter the dream. Find yourself a calm place where you won't be interrupted. Take a few minutes to relax and move into the landscape of the dream. Have an alarm set on a quiet tone. Extra important if you are in a different places because you have to do this at the same time, as said. Afterwards, write down what you remember and talk about it. Sometimes the answer comes the first session, but more often it doesn't. And with a new common material, though, there's a better position for the next session. And re-entering a dream is never unnecessary work. So even if it takes time to get the answer to the question, to understand the message, every second is in consciously chosen dream time is one step closer to the key that gives you access to the realm of dreams. So do dream, bless you all, and much love to you. Bye bye.